metta, to practice metta, and to develop metta, you need a context that is supporting that, without it being too soft and too sweet and too everything is possible. We are happy with everything. So metta is not about sentiments. Metta is about, you know, it's a real clear open heart practice. And you work for it, you know, it's not just there. It is there, but you know, we have to work for it, enable it for it to shine. One of the principles, and our architect defined that very well, is that it should be comfortable without pampering. So you should not feel too much at home. It has to challenge you in a way, you know, without being ascetic. So what we have tried to do, not only in the design, but also in the way we decorated it, is to make people feel comfortable and challenge them at the same time.
It's unfussy and it's functional. There's nothing to distract, or not much to distract. On the whole, front and back are kind of quite close together, and they're open both ends, which hopefully will invite people to kind of open up in themselves too, to kind of flow out of yourself, out into the nature around. But that takes, you know, that takes a bit of courage.
The relationship with the landscape. So we have these high windows, like the glass, so the difference between the inside and outside is very subtle in a way. You're there in the landscape, walking in the building, whether it's winter or summer or spring or snow or whatever.
For 5 years we had about 20 retreats a year, renting different accommodations. Our original idea was the spreading of the Dharma in the Low Countries, and I think that still holds. We see it as two pillars. One pillar of Metta-vihara, which would say deepening the practice, so particularly for those people who Buddhism and or meditation already has a place in their life, so you want to help them to deepen their practice. But at the same time, you want to broaden, you want to widen, because you want to attract more people. Not so much because we want to be bigger, but because you want more people to benefit from the practice of meditation and from what the Buddha had to say, you know, what really contributes to real happiness. In many ways, all we need is metta. And you want the world to know that. You want the world to know that all we need is some friendliness, some kindness, some empathy. Occasionally putting yourself in somebody's shoes, you know, not only walking in your own worn out familiar shoes. Can get boring, can't it? Your own shoes. So in a way that's metta, you know, trying to understand, to empathize, to sympathize. Through deepening our experience of metta, we can broaden. The widening, the reaching out, has to come from our own practice. It can't be something superficial.
The real fundament of a spiritual life is metta. You see, many Buddhists are looking for enlightenment or for awakening or for emptiness. But the basic problem of life is what the Buddha stated in the Kalama Sutta, that we are all driven by greed, by hatred, and by illusion. That's the real problem of life, where all suffering comes from. There is only one way to get out of it, and that way is opening up, is stopping of being a grabbing person, a person who pushes away everything he doesn't like, and the person just telling himself fairy stories. And when you do that, well, then automatically you come in a completely different state of mind, and that state of mind is metta. And, the fulfillment of it is called awakening, and that fulfillment is just metta, which has become completely, completely limitless.
We hold about 4 vision days a year. Those days are really meant to bring all the people together who are in one way or another involved in the practical running of the project. So that counts to about 30 volunteers from both countries, Holland and Belgium. From the trustees of Metavihara and the vision group, we keep sharing our ideal and our vision for the place and for Bente's vision and how we want to translate that here.
Metavihara is more than just a place where you mow the grass and where you clean and where you cook food. It's more than that. And there's more to learn in a way. And Meta as a driving force in doing that together.
In a way, the vision is enormous, and at the same time, it's so small in how to put it into practice. The practice is in the smallness of things. You know, nobody would argue with me about the importance of kindness in the world. But when it actually comes to being kind, you know, that is what it's all about. That is what will change the world.
I don't think I exaggerate that everybody who has been here goes away as slightly more kind and friendly. You know? This building is not just a building, it's a living organism. You know, breathing in and out and spreading metta and kindness and, you know, absorbing it.
Metta!
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 Again!
It is a statement of metta. I think that's the most simple way to put it. It's a statement of metta. Yeah. Yeah.